always amazes me when you look at the seabed, how colourful it is. And it's amazing reds and blues and greens and fantastic colours. And the amount of life, you know, it's an incredible amount of diversity. And there's probably, you know, hundreds of creatures in a very small area just underneath this boat. And then you multiply that by the size of the Arctic that we're in, and it's just, it's mind-blowing. I came here 5 years ago, and we did a load of documentation in this area, but 5 years ago, we could see the sea ice from here. Now the sea ice is about 4 hours sailing that way. And what's happening is that the trawlers are moving up behind the sea ice, so they're now trawling in areas that they never used to trawl before.
So the areas that have not been fished before, they look amazing. But the areas that have been trawled, they look completely different. Like everything is like tumbled over. You can really see the marks that the trawl nets leave on the seabed. And yeah, nothing is in its original place anymore. Recently, a number of big fishing and seafood companies have voluntarily agreed to stay out of these pristine Arctic waters. And that's a great first step. But what we need is long-term and legal protection for these waters. So that's why we're calling on the Norwegian government to create a marine protected area in the waters around Svalbard.
So what we're trying to do at the moment is document areas, hopefully before the trawlers get into them, because otherwise nobody's looked at this area, nobody's looked at this seabed. So the trawlers could come in here and just wipe out species before they're even documented by science.
These waters are some of the last on Earth that have never been fished before that really remain untouched. So the Arctic offers us a second chance in that sense that we can still do the right thing here. We can still protect these waters and keep them off limits to industrial activities.